Hey, it's Mike here, and I gotta be honest with you, since arriving here in Cyprus, I've found it really hard to get any work done, particularly vibe coding. I feel like I've been off the train and out the loop for 30 days, and that's enough to be almost a lifetime in AI. So this video will be rather raw, unedited, and me attempting to build something to get back on the AI train. How am I going to do it? I'm going to use Replit. And one thing I've been doing daily since arriving here is swimming. Now, it's fantastic and all that, but it's rather cold. In fact, I bought this gadget here that tells me it's currently 9.6 degrees Celsius. That's really cold. Despite being sunny most days here in Cyprus, that is still Iceman protocol. So now I've got some data there. I've also got this brilliant wearable that my wife bought for me for my birthday late last year. It's an Oura Ring, and you'll see here, Oura on the web gives me my resting heart rate, my total sleep time over the days, and also my activity burn. It's really, really cool, but I find that kind of clunky, having to hop into Oura, sometimes going into my Garmin, sometimes looking at the weather, and also using this brand new device that monitors the temperature of my swimming pool. I want to bring this all together into a really cool app that I can vibe code that can just tell me if I should swim and for how much before I need to get out and start shivering. I've got to say, it's one of the best biohacks I've done since arriving here. It's changed me from having a very low readiness score and very disrupted sleep to having near perfect readiness scores daily. That's great for my physical health, hasn't been so good for my productivity so far. So I'm hoping this will get me back into it. And so here in Replit, I'm going to say, design me an Iceman protocol app that looks at some key Oura Ring stats daily and asks for my swimming pool temp as an input and records the date and all data to a database. The external tool you will need is the Oura API and connect that using this method. Okay, that I think is a really good vibe coding first prompt. And if I go into Oura API, this is their latest documentation. So it says that you need to authorize using OAuth 2, so that's fine. I'm actually just going to copy that whole thing by hitting Command A, Command C, going back to Replit and pasting that all in. Now I'm hoping with that first prompt and the Oura API access that it will go ahead and create something amazing for me. I overcomplicated this. Before I made this video, I was kind of thinking, maybe like you do when you're vibe coding, hey, I need to pull in stuff from my Garmin watch and I need latest temperatures and wind directions and things. And I kind of felt like I was trying to over-engineer this app. And I think we suffer from that a lot. So right here, you can see already Replit Agent is working on what it's calling my cold plunge tracker. I really like that. The cold plunge tracker, the Oura Ring Iceman protocol app. Okay, this is fantastic. Already it's coming back and asking for an Oura client ID and client secret. So over here in Oura, again, I can see I need to create a developer account. I've signed in. That was really easy. I can create a new account. And here we go. We can call it something. Okay, I've filled out the details. I'm giving it access to everything from my Oura Ring so that Replit can decide what it needs, agree, and create. This is really cool. It's created my app, the cold plunge tracker. So now I can go back. I've pasted those values in here and I can continue. Now over here, we can see it says I have the Oura credentials. It's making a task list for making that Iceman protocol app. And it's starting by building the schema and all the front end components. Now you'll notice this has been working away on 7 different actions and then pages with 4 different actions. And now it's wiring everything together. And it's updating the storage and database and backend routes. This is really cool. And look at this. Wow. I had a tendency to over-engineer things. I think AI has a tendency to over-engineer things. This is absolutely insane in terms of what it's presented to me. But let's check it out and see if it actually works. Okay, you can actually see here it's testing my app. The Replit agent is clicking around and testing out dark mode and other various features of the app. Okay, all tests passed successfully. It's given me a nice summary here. It seems to be good. I've just typed down here, make Celsius the default unit as I'm UK European. And I'll go to fast mode to see if I can add that to the queue to be updated so we get a Celsius unit by default for the pool temperature. It's also discovered a few faults that it's fixing automatically before it gets to my queue item. This is really cool, and it is the idea of an autonomous coding agent that can just build the app for you. I love this. Okay, we're in a good place. It's even asking me if I want to publish this app, but I'll go to the preview and give it a quick refresh, and we can actually test this app out and see how it works. So today, when I went for a swim, it was 8.9 Celsius. Let's record the temperature. Now, I notice it's still referring to Fahrenheit here, so I'm just going to fast fix that by telling the Replit agent to do the work for me. Now, back over here for today's date, 8.9, record temperature. Yes, we've got the correct pool temperature, and this is not historically stored yet. Let's refresh and double check. Now we have a correct pool temperature here of 8.9, historically stored for today. This is a great start, but does it connect to Aura without me needing to do much? Let's try the connect button here. And yes, I can send myself a code and sign in and consent to my app having all of this data about me, which is absolutely fine. And boom, look at that. Within just a few minutes of vibe coding an app, it gives my sleep score, my readiness score, my HRV average, my resting heart rate, and my total sleep, which doesn't look correct here and doesn't look correct here. So there's more to be changed, but you can see how within a few minutes, I'm starting to get an MVP of an app that I can build on. Also, when I scroll down here, I can actually see it's pulled in some historical data as well. Sleep and readiness look about right, but the HRV and sleep duration, I definitely don't sleep for 2 minutes every night. Let's update that in the Replit agent. Okay, so I've typed in here, connecting my Oura Ring works, but it seems HRV average, resting heart rate, and total sleep, e.g. showing just 2 minutes, is incorrect. Please fix. I'm going to switch off fast mode and run the agent on this to see if we can get accurate data into my app. Okay, I can see the values are still wrong despite the agent finishing, but it does say to update, go to settings and sync now. So let's do that. Here we are in the main app. We'll go to settings and we've got sync now. So let's click that. Okay, sync is complete. Back to my dashboard. Nice and clean. And this is looking a lot better. Yes, these are looking like my figures. And that was definitely the amount of sleep I had last night. So we're on to a winner here. Let's just refresh the app again. Okay, it's still wrong. I can see January 14 should be 8 hours, 15 minutes of sleep and an HRV of 61 milliseconds. Why does it not work? Please try harder to fix this. I really want to get this working. Okay, found it. The issue was that when you have multiple sleep sessions like naps in a day and things like that, we're only keeping the last one. So it's fixing that. And it tells me syncing now should actually work. I love it. It's like working with a tradesperson who's not very reliable. Now I have the correct HRV and sleep duration. Phew, that took way longer than I thought. So I've cut this video down to size, but it's taken me about 3/4 of an hour to make this MVP app. Now, obviously, I'd like to add more to it. I'd like to be able to share my Garmin swim data so we can see how I'm doing in the water, maybe a bit of nutrition advice as well and things like that. But this is a great MVP, and it shows still how easy and how much easier it's getting to make things with a few annoying little bits where it just won't do something until you ask it 3 times. Yeah, it's great, but it's getting there. So the final thing I'm going to do just for OCD is switch on fast mode. And we can see here under log pool temperature, we say the columns, or should I say, columns and rows are not aligned nicely. Please tidy up. And we'll see if we can get the date and temperature and unit all on the same level, because this just really plays wrong with my OCD at the moment. Okay, we've let it work. And actually, that took just moments. It's just refreshing the preview again, but I can see it was already done for me right there. Now we've got the date. We've got the temperature of the pool. Unit looks even better. We can choose C or F, and we can record that pool temperature. This is exactly what I want daily. I want my Oura Ring stats pulled in, stored historically in a database that Replit has made, and then eventually I'm going to drag in my swim data as well so I can keep improving. And ultimately, over time, I want historical records, but I also want to add AI to this app so it can tell me what kind of workouts I should do, i.e. how long should I be in the pool for based on the temperature, how many lengths should I do, what should my recovery look like? But this is a great introduction to biohacking made easy with AI and a little bit of vibe coding. I hope you found some kind of value, and maybe there's something you'd recommend I add to this app. I'm really open to your suggestions. Maybe I'll develop this further and add more integrations. Let me know in the comments down below what you think, and keep subscribed to the channel. Throw a like on this video if you enjoyed it, as I'll be doing more videos just like this one and ramping up into way more content for 2026 as I get back onto that very fast AI moving train. Thank you so much for watching, and YouTube is showing a video on your screen now. You should watch next. Thanks.